next time on eHarlem TV. We'll meet Tito El Bombero, an 8-year-old bilingual boy who helps real New York City firefighters save the day.
Special unit.
Engine 91, first due, 250 East 111th Street. Fire on the 4th floor, apartment 4C. Engine 91, first due.
Over 11,000 men and women make up New York's fire department, responding to thousands of calls every day. In our neighborhood, we have 125 firefighters spread across 3 firehouses. Together, they receive about 18,000 calls a year, some for emergencies and some not. At that rate, it seems the trucks are always coming and going.
Hi, I'm Tim Hoppe. I'm a firefighter at Engine 91. I've been here for 25 years, and I still love the job. I did graduate from college, but when I got out, I knew I didn't want to be working in an office. I wanted an exciting profession, and I just saw the ad in the newspaper and decided to take the test. It wasn't something I thought about doing my whole life, but as soon as I saw that ad, I just knew that you know, I wanted that to be my vocation.
Today, 6 kids from the Rising Stars program at Union Settlement House are in for a special treat. They're visiting Engine Company 91 on 111th Street, just off 2nd Avenue. Hi, I'm Elise Rivera, kid reporter for eHarlem TV. Every girl and boy dreams of riding on a fire truck, but not everyone has a chance to see one up close and actually try out the equipment. These lucky kids got to, and a little boy named Tito. Watch out for that truck.
Welcome to Engine 91. I'm Firefighter Tim. This is Firefighter Mike.
Hello.
Firefighter Joey.
What's up, guys?
Firefighter Ryan.
Hello.
And Firefighter George.
Hola.
This firehouse that you're visiting today is almost 100 years old. And for that long, the firefighters stationed here have been protecting the people of this neighborhood. But anyway, don't just stand there. Come on in. Let's go in.
Awesome. We are all playing. Go into the chairs over here, kids.
But in addition to being a firefighter, I'm also an author. And today I'm going to read to you a book that I wrote. This story takes place right here in Spanish Harlem, right here in the neighborhood where you live. It's called Tito the Firefighter, Tito el Bombero. In what language is that?
Spanish.
Spanish, very, very good. All right, there's going to be some Spanish words in the story. Anytime you see a word in red letters, that word is in Spanish. But don't worry, you don't have to understand Spanish to understand the story. Usually the Spanish word follows right after an English word of the exact same meaning. Okay, we'll just wait till they go out. All right, let's read the story. Tito the firefighter, Tito el Bombero. Hello. Hola. My name is Tito. I live in East Harlem, where almost everyone speaks Spanish. When my mother sends me to the store for milk and eggs, I ask for leche y huevos. Tito was really, it was two different ideas I had that kind of converged to form the basis for the book. The first one was, there used to be a little boy who lived next door, in the tenement next door to the firehouse, named Luis Cruz, and Tito was actually dedicated to him. But when he was a younger boy, he used to plague the daylights out of us to ride on the fire engine, and it was always no, no, no. I mean, we let him climb all over it in quarters, but he always wanted to ride on it. So I always had that idea in the back of my head. And then also I just noticed that when we went out on runs, we were often trying to find out from adults who only spoke Spanish what the situation was. And oftentimes it was the children who could interpret for the adults, because many of the firemen are only English speaking and many of the adults in this community are only Spanish speaking. And it's just that a lot of the children are bilingual. And so I just kind of took those two ideas and that formed the basis for the book. Richie could tell that the man needed help, but he could not understand the man's Espanol. I ran over and spoke English for the man. A smoke detector was ringing in the man's building. He thought he smelled smoke. The fire truck raced down the street. The horn and siren were loud. The horn in La Serena sent out a message. Look out! Tenga cuidado! We raced past the man who had told us about the fire. Hurry! Apúrense! He shouted. There was not a fire in the building. There was no fuego at all. A woman fell asleep and took a siesta while cooking. She burned a pot of rice. Still, it was exciting. The old men playing dominoes pointed at me and cheered when I climbed out of El Camión de Bomberos. Thanks for the help. Gracias, said Richie. You're welcome. De nada, I said. Because I am bilingual, I got to be a bombero for a day. Now when I walk past the firehouse, I yell to Richie, Hola, bombero! Richie yells back, Hola, Tito, our little bombero. So Tito got to ride in the fire truck after all, didn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.